गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द टॉपिक दैट वाज गोइंग ऑन इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास, दैट इज आवर पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड। टुडे वी विल सी इन डिटेल्स अबाउट द एंटीरियर पिट्यूटरी। बट बिफोर गोइंग टू द एंटीरियर पिट्यूटरी, लेट्स हैव अ ब्रीफ recapitulation of what we have studied in the previous class in general about the pituitary gland. So pituitary and the hypothalamus together, they form a single functional unit. The pituitary gland consists of two lobes. One is your anterior pituitary, other one is your posterior. This one is your anterior pituitary and your posterior pituitary. The anterior pituitary or the anterior lobe is otherwise known as your adenohypophysis. The posterior pituitary or the posterior lobe is also known as your neural lobe, also neurohypophysis. Again, the anterior pituitary is divided into three parts. First one is your pars distalis, second one is your pars intermedia, and the third one is your pars tubalis. Then posterior pituitary, again it consists of three other components. First one is your median eminence, then comes your infundibular stem or the infundibular, and the last one is the infundibular process. The anterior pituitary, it is influenced by hormones which comes from the hypothalamus via your hypothalamo-hypophyseal portal vessels. So now a question for you is, how many okay, so PPT is not visible. Is it visible now? Okay, PPT not visible. Just give me a minute, I'll come back. Just ask them what's the problem. Wait for a minute. पीपीटी विजिबल नहीं है बोल रहे।
इसे मिनिमाइज कर देंगे ना?
नहीं फिर भी नहीं हो रहा ये, लेकिन उनको नहीं हो रहा है तो इसलिए थोड़ा एक मिनट
इसको आप मिनिमाइज कर देंगे फिर देखिएगा। यस
इज द पीपीटी विजिबल नाउ? ओके सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू। ओके आई एम ऑडिबल एज वेल एज द पीपीटी इज विजिबल। ओके ओके सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड विद द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड। नाउ यू टेल मी how many portal systems are present in the body? How many portal systems are present in the body? Three. ओके रौनक शर्मा 3, ओके भाविक 2, ओके सो यू हैव रिटेन हेपेटिक एज वेल एज योर हाइपोफेसियल। ओके सो दोज हु आर टेलिंग 3, व्हाट इज द थर्ड वन एक्सेप्ट हेपेटिक एंड हाइपोफेसियल? ओके रीनल वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट इट, रीनल हाइपोफेसियल, एनीथिंग एल्स? Anything else? Those who are telling 3. Is PPT visible now? So anterior pituitary, it is influenced by hormones which comes from the hypothalamus via your hypothalamo hypophyseal portal system or the portal vessels, and the posterior pituitary, it is influenced by the hypothalamo hypophyseal neural tract again, which conveys hormones directly from the hypothalamic nuclei and which can be stored in your posterior pituitary. Now coming to the hormones of the anterior pituitary, there are 6 important hormones of anterior pituitary, starting with your growth hormone, or it is termed as your somatotrophin. Then coming to your thyroid stimulating hormone, otherwise termed as your TSH or thyrotropin. Then coming to the adrenocorticotropic hormone or ACTH or corticotropin, follicle stimulating hormone FSH, and luteinizing hormone LH together are termed as your gonadotropic hormone, and the last one is your prolactin. Except these 6 important hormones that are secreted by your anterior pituitary, a recently added hormone has been included in it. It is called as your beta lipotrophin or beta LPH. Am I audible? Slides are visible till now? Okay. So we have 6 important hormones: growth hormone, then you have your TSH, ACTH, FSH, LH, and prolactin. Other hormones include your beta lipotrophin. So what is the histology of this anterior pituitary hormones? Okay. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स एंड दिस टू आर डिफ्रेंशिएटेड बाय देयर स्टेनिंग प्रॉपर्टीज. फर्स्ट वन इज योर क्रोमोफोब सेल्स. First one is your chromophore cells. So these do not possess the granules, first property, and they stain very poorly. It constitute about 50% of the total anterior pituitary cells. Do not stain properly and do not possess granules. These again are non-secretory in nature. But the importance of this type of cells is that they are the precursors for your chromophyll cells. Okay, these chromophyll cells are your secretory in nature, and they are subdivided into two types according to the stains they take. First one is your acidophilic, or called as your alpha cells. Next is your basophils, or called as your beta cells. Again, this is divided, the chromophyll cells are divided into five different types according to the hormone they secrete. Somatotrophs secrete growth hormone, lactotrophs secrete prolactin, corticotrophs secrete ACTH and beta lipotropin, thyrotrophs secrete your TSH, and gonadotrophs secrete your LH and FSH. Okay, slides are visible, but I am not visible. Okay, the system they have made it such that I won't be visible, but only my voice is. Is it audible? Slides are visible. If slides are visible and I am audible, then we can continue with the classes, but I won't be visible to you. Okay, those who are saying no means, okay, slides not visible. Again, the same problem. So I don't think so there is any problem from this side. You check your net connection, otherwise there will be a problem from your side, because the slides are visible here. Okay, so two types of cells. First one is your chromophobe cells, and the second one is your chromophyll cells. The chromophobe cells are non-secretory in nature, and the chromophyll cells are secretory in nature, and they are of five different types. So see this diagram. The acidophil cells are your pink cells, light pink cells. Okay, they have pink cytoplasm and pink nucleus. The basophil cells are your purple cells, light violet purple cells. Cytoplasm is violet and the nucleus is also violet. And the chromophobe cells are small cells in between the acidophils and the basophils. Okay, so can you see the diagram? The pink cells are your acidophil cells, the purple cells are your basophil cells, and the small dotted structure in between the two varieties of cells are your chromophobe cells. See, again this table will demonstrate which type of cells and staining property and which hormone is secreted. Somatotrophs, they are growth hormone, they are acidophilic in nature. then lactotrophs, they are again acidophilic in nature and they will secrete prolactin. Corticotrophs, they are basophilic in nature and will secrete ACTH. Thyrotrophs are again basophilic in nature, will secrete TSH. Gonadotrophs, those are your LH and FSH. And those are basophilic in nature. Okay, so the somatotrophs consist of about 40 to 50% of the total cells. So the growth hormone secretion from the cells is maximum because it consists of 40 to 50%. The next comes your prolactin and ACTH, that is around 10 to 25 or 10 to 20. Then LH and FSH consist of about 10 to 15% of the total cells of anterior pituitary, and the rest, very less, 3 to 5% goes for your TSH. Again, you are having the same problem. PPT not visible. Okay, you had the same problem. PPT not visible, just like yesterday. Okay, coming to the next slide, this is very important, regulation of anterior pituitary secretion. So the hypothalamus is the main control organ of your anterior pituitary because it secretes releasing or the inhibitory hormones, which are termed as your neurohormones. Last class we have seen about it. And what are those? There are five in nature. First one is your growth hormone releasing hormone. Next is your thyrotropin releasing hormone. Then comes to your gonadotropin releasing hormone. Then your corticotropin releasing hormone. And the last one is your prolactin releasing factor. So the ones that have a positive impact are coming for your anterior pituitary secretion, and the ones that have a negative impact, that is both somatostatin and dopamine. The rest five hormones that are secretory in nature and has a positive impact are your growth hormone releasing hormone, then your thyrotropin releasing hormone, corticotropin releasing hormone, then your gonadotropin releasing hormone, and the last one is your prolactin releasing factor. All this will have a positive effect on your pituitary hormones. So the gonadotropin hormone, growth hormone releasing hormone, will have a positive effect on your growth hormone, and somatostatin will have a negative effect or inhibitory effect on your growth hormone. Similarly, the rest of the hormones. So the hypothalamic hormones, they affect the release of your pituitary hormones that will again affect the target tissues which has the major functions uploaded. So the target tissues for growth hormone is your somatic tissues and your liver. For TSH it is your thyroid, for ACTH it is your adrenal cortex, for your LH and FSH they are your gonads, and the prolactin on your breast. So what is the major function of your growth hormone? It is for growth, development and metabolism. This we will see all this in the coming classes. Thyroid, T3, T4 secretion, then ACTH for your cortisol secretion, LH and FSH for your gonadal hormone secretion, and prolactin for your lactogenesis. Okay, so the regulation of anterior pituitary secretion, this may come as your side question to your anterior pituitary, and it is a must question. So you have to remember all this. What are the hormones that have a positive impact? What are the hormones that have the negative impact on your pituitary hormones? What are the pituitary hormones? Then what are the target tissues of these pituitary hormones? And what are the functions of your pituitary hormones? So first, coming to the growth hormone. So let's have a basic introduction to the growth hormone structure, synthesis and secretion. So it is, growth hormone is otherwise termed as a somatotropin. It's a very important hormone for your postnatal growth and development of your adult size. It helps to maintain the body mass, bone mass in adults. And the structure, if you see, it is a single unbranched chain which consists of 191 amino acids with 2 disulfide bonds. It is synthesized by the acidophilic cells, that we have already seen, okay, and it consists of total of 40 to 50% of the total anterior pituitary cells. Secretion, growth hormone is released in a very pulsatile fashion, that means it is either increased or decreased and it doesn't have a regular pattern. Increased secretion is seen in your sleep, stress, starvation, during exercise, and your decreased secretion is seen in by the effect of somatostatin, somatomedins, obesity and during pregnancy. This table will demonstrate to you the factors which affect your growth hormone secretion. Factors which increase growth hormone secretion and factors which decrease growth hormone secretion. The factors, the main one is your hypoglycemia, and it occurs during your exercise and fasting. Then if you have a high protein meal, hormones also help, estrogens, acetylcholine, serotonin, androgens. If you have stress during fever, surgery or any psychological trauma, during puberty, what is this, and during sleep, this we will see in details now. Then the drugs also affect, and the factors that decrease your secretion, when there is increase in glucose and free fatty acid level in your blood, when there is hormones action, that is cortisol, then REM sleep, obesity and pregnancy. So the factors which increase secretion, the factors which decrease secretion will have a direct impact on your growth hormone secretion. Next, coming to the regulation of growth hormone secretion, first one is your hypothalamic control. In the last class, I have already told you how the hypothalamus controls your secretion of growth hormone by two important hormones. The first one is your growth hormone releasing hormone. The other one is your growth hormone inhibiting hormone, or the growth hormone release inhibiting hormone. So two hormones, growth hormone releasing hormone, growth hormone release inhibiting hormone. Coming to this diagram, you see the hypothalamus is direct action through growth hormone releasing hormone, it has a positive action, and growth hormone inhibiting hormone, it has a negative action on your anterior pituitary. The next type of control is your negative feedback control of growth hormone secretion. It involves three mechanisms. One is your somatomedins, next is your again your growth hormone, and the last one is your growth hormone releasing hormone. So how somatomedins act? They inhibit the secretion of growth hormone either directly by stimulating secretion of somatostatin, or indirectly by secretion from your somatostatin from hypothalamus. So either directly or indirectly by stimulating secretion of somatostatin from your hypothalamus. So this plays a negative control to your growth hormone secretion. The next one is by your growth hormone itself. How does this act? The growth hormone will inhibit its own secretion either by stimulating secretion of somatostatin from the hypothalamus through again growth hormone action through your somatostatin. The last one is the negative feedback control by growth hormone releasing hormone. This will inhibit its own secretion from the hypothalamus, and this is termed as your ultra short feedback loop. Okay, this mechanism of action that controls the secretion of growth hormone via your growth hormone releasing hormone from the hypothalamus is termed as your ultra short feedback loop. So negative feedback control mainly by your somatomedins, growth hormone again dependent on the somatomedins, and the last one is a growth hormone releasing hormone. Hypothalamic control by two hormones, that is the growth hormone releasing hormone and the growth hormone inhibiting hormone. The negative feedback control by somatomedins, growth hormone and growth hormone releasing hormone. The next is the plasma level binding and metabolism of anterior pituitary hormone. The basic plasma, basal plasma growth hormone level varies from 2 to 4 ng per ml, and the concentration graph shows you the fluctuation. That is, after every 1 to 2 hour interval, there is a rise in plasma growth hormone level. Again, this is because it has the diurnal variation which occurs after 1 to 2 hours after your deep sleep. So if you see this graph, you can see the secretion of growth hormone is maximum in the midnight and it's more in the noon compared to the other hours of your day. So 2/3 of secretions occurs during the midnight. Why? Because there is variation in plasma growth hormone level during your that is 1 to 2 hours after deep sleep. So morning, noon time you have high concentration of plasma growth hormone and maximum during your midnight. वेरिएशन इन प्लाज्मा ग्रोथ हार्मोन लेवल्स ऑल्सो चेंजेस अकॉर्डिंग टू योर एज. सो फ्रॉम बर्थ टू अर्ली चाइल्डहुड लेवल द ग्रोथ हार्मोन विल इंक्रीज प्रोग्रेसिवली, बट चिल्ड्रेन विल हैव अ वेरी स्लाइट हायर प्लाज्मा लेवल देन कंपेयर टू योर एडल्ट. एंड द मैक्सिमम पीक लेवल ऑफ प्लाज्मा ग्रोथ हार्मोन इज सीन ड्यूरिंग योर प्यूबर्टी, दैट इज ड्यूरिंग योर ग्रोथ पीरियड. And there is decrease in your growth hormone during your senescence, because again due to the response of your growth hormone releasing hormone, which is reduced in your senescence, and so there is decrease in your growth hormone secretion. So maximum level of plasma growth hormone levels is seen during your puberty. Children have very less. Children have slightly higher plasma level compared to that of adults, and from birth to your early childhood there will be slight increase or gradual increase in your plasma growth hormone level. This diagram will illustrate, see, during infancy there is increase, during childhood there is increase, but sudden increase during your puberty. Then slowly there is a plateau phase during your adult life, which will slowly decrease during your old age. So the maximum amount of plasma growth hormone level is seen during your puberty. Circulation, half-life and metabolism of growth hormone. The growth hormone during its circulation is bound to the plasma protein that is termed as a growth hormone binding protein, and the half-life of circulating growth hormone in humans is about 0 to 20 minutes only, and the daily growth hormone output is 0.2 to 1 mg per day in adult. The degradation of growth hormone occurs in your liver and kidney. Till now, have you understood whatever have been taught? Am I visible? Okay. So till now whatever has been taught you have understood. From the slides you have to remember what are the different hormones of your anterior pituitary cells, then regulation of anterior pituitary secretion is very very important. Growth hormone itself comes as a long question. For that you just have to write down in basis about the different the structure, synthesis, just one line. Secretion, regulation is important, so you have to write down in details about the regulation of growth hormone secretion, the feedback mechanism, positive and negative feedback mechanism. Then from this you may get give reason questions. Okay. And now this is the last one, actions of growth hormone, and again this is very very important, that is functions of your growth hormone. Again it is divided into many types. First one, starting with growth promoting actions of growth hormone, which is the very important one. That is growth hormone, it promotes your linear growth of an individual by, it affects the two important structures of your body. One is your cartilage, other one is your bone. Cartilage, as you all know, it is present, or it is the chondrocytes, these are present in the epiphyseal end plate of the long bones, which are the main centers for your growth, and in the bone this effect as it helps into stimulate the conversion of the cartilage into your bone. So this will continue up to adolescence, as you all know, because up till there will be the fusion of your epiphyseal implant with the shaft of the bone. So till your adolescence there will be effect on the bone, and till the conversion of the cartilage to bone there will be effect on the cartilage. So growth hormone will stimulate both the cartilage and the bone for increase in their growth. The next action, that is metabolic action, and the next important action of growth hormone is growth hormone influences different metabolism. The first one is your protein metabolism. How? It increases the rate of amino acid uptake in the cells. First. Next, it increases the protein synthesis in ribosome. And the last one, it stimulates transcription mechanism, that is RNA synthesis from DNA. So by these three mechanisms, it helps in your promotion, or it promotes the protein deposition in the tissue. Increased rate of amino acid uptake, increased protein synthesis in ribosome, and it stimulates transcription. The next effect is on fat metabolism. In fat metabolism, it promotes lipolysis in the adipose tissue. This is a catabolic effect, and then that will increase the fat utilization for energy. So what is catabolic effect? Anyone can tell me? What do you mean by catabolic effect? Breakdown, splitting, okay. Yes, breaking into simpler form. Okay, breakdown into your simpler forms. So, growth hormone promotes catabolic effect. So this is the diagram or the chart. If you draw this, you will remember the I'm giving you time to draw this diagram so that you can remember the total function of growth hormone, that is it helps in growth promoting action and in metabolic actions. So growth promoting actions, see here, hypothalamus release growth hormone releasing hormone. That will have a positive effect on your anti-repetitory hormone, which will release your growth hormone. So it affects your liver and other organs to release your somatomedins, which will affect either your skeletal tissue or extraskeletal tissue for your skeletal growth and your tissue growth. Why are your cortisol? It has three important: protein, fat and carbohydrate. Protein, you have seen, it will increase the protein synthesis. Fat again increase your lipoprotein, and we'll see carbohydrate, it will increase blood glucose and other anti-insulin action. So I'm giving you time to just draw this diagram in your rough, okay, or just take a screenshot and keep. So you can enlarge the screen size of your cell phone and just take a screenshot and keep this picture, okay. So this will help you to remember the various function of your growth hormone. Over. Should I? Okay, should I move to the other slides? So metabolic action, first one to your proteins, next to your fats, then coming to the carbohydrate. The growth hormone is a pro-diabetogenic hormone. Why? Because it causes your hyperglycemia. So how it causes? First, it will increases the release of glucose from liver by facilitating your hepatic neoglucogenesis. Again, you must have studied in details about your neoglucogenesis in your biochemistry class. So it increases the release of glucose from liver by facilitating hepatic neoglucogenesis. Again, decreases glucose uptake by your skeletal muscle and decreases insulin sensitivity. In these three mechanism, it causes your hyperglycemia. The last effect is on your mineral metabolism. So you learnt about protein, fat, carbohydrate, minerals. So minerals, it has a very it promotes your bone mineralization in growing children or during your puberty, and it also promotes your renal absorption of your calcium, phosphate and sodium, very important. Again, renal retention of sodium, potassium, chloride in your body. Absorption of calcium, phosphate and sodium, retention of sodium, potassium, calcium in your body. So these are the four different methods by which the growth hormone acts on the metabolic functions in your body. The last effect is on lactation, which enhances milk production in your lactating animals. You know this, and also this acts like the prolactin. Okay, so Amrutmayi, you want me to repeat initial 3-4 slides, and which explanation is required for you? Amrutmayi, am I audible? So I have written down, okay, yes ma'am, okay. So you have written down to repeat initial 3-4 slides, okay. Which 3-4 slides? Initial of functions of the growth hormone or starting 3-4 slides? Okay, those slides are not visible. Which slides are not visible? Starting slides of today's class. Okay, so I will again describe to you. Have you completed with the functions of growth hormone? Would you like me to repeat the functions of growth hormone? Okay, so you have studied about the functions of growth hormone. Okay, so if you want me to repeat the initial slides of today's class. Okay, we started introduction to the posterior pituitary, anterior pituitary, okay. Then the next slide was hormones of anterior pituitary. Now the slides are visible. Okay, so the first 6 इंपॉर्टेंट हार्मोन्स, ग्रोथ हार्मोन, TSH, ACTH, FSH, LH एंड प्रोलैक्टिन. दिस आर द 6 इंपॉर्टेंट हार्मोन्स सिक्रेटेड बाय द एंटीरियर पिट्यूटरी. द अदर न्यूली एडेड इज योर बीटा लाइपोट्रोफिन अलॉन्ग विद दिस 6 इंपॉर्टेंट हार्मोन्स. ओके, सो दिस वॉज योर सेकेंड स्लाइड. द थर्ड स्लाइड इज योर हिस्टोलॉजी स्लाइड. ओके, सो वी स्टडीड अबाउट टू सेल्स. फर्स्ट वन इज योर क्रोमोफोब सेल्स विच आर नॉन सिक्रेटरी इन नेचर. दे डू नॉट स्टेन प्रॉपरली एंड दे कंस्टिट्यूट अबाउट योर 50% टोटल सेल्स ऑफ योर एंटीरियर पिट्यूटरी. एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑफ दिस क्रोमोफोब सेल्स इज दैट दे आर द प्रिकॉसर्स ऑफ द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ सेल्स, दैट इज योर क्रोमोफिल सेल्स विच आर सिक्रेटरी इन नेचर, अगेन डिवाइडेड इंटू 5 डिफरेंट टाइप्स. द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. ओके, द 5 डिफरेंट टाइप्स. ग्रोथ हार्मोन इज सिक्रेटेड फ्रॉम योर सोमैटोट्रॉप्स, प्रोलैक्टिन फ्रॉम योर लैक्टोट्रॉप्स, ACTH एंड योर बीटा लाइपोट्रोफिन फ्रॉम योर कॉर्टिकोट्रॉप्स, TSH फ्रॉम योर थायरोट्रॉप्स, LH एंड FSH फ्रॉम योर गोनाडोट्रॉप्स. क्लियर? ओके, द नेक्स्ट वॉज योर डायग्राम विच डेमोन्स्ट्रेटेड द एसिडोफिलिक सेल्स विच आर लाइट पिंक इन कलर. सी दिस सेल्स आर लाइट पिंक इन कलर विथ पिंक न्यूक्लियस. एंड योर बेसोफिलिक सेल्स आर वायलेट इन कलर विथ योर डार्क वायलेट न्यूक्लियस. द स्मॉल डॉट्स इन बिटवीन द टू वेराइटी ऑफ सेल्स आर योर क्रोमोफोब सेल्स. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड इज अ टेबल विच शोज द विच टाइप ऑफ सेल्स सिक्रीट्स वॉट टाइप ऑफ हार्मोन एंड वॉट इज द स्टेनिंग प्रॉपर्टीज. सोमैटोट्रॉप्स, लैक्टोट्रॉप्स, कॉर्टिकोट्रॉप्स, थायरोट्रॉप्स एंड गोनाडोट्रॉप्स. ओके, आई थिंक इट विल बी ओके विथ यू. एनी अदर स्लाइड्स यू वॉन्ट टू रिपीट? ओके, सो कमिंग आफ्टर ग्रोथ हार्मोन, देर आर ऑल्सो अदर हार्मोन्स विच आर सिक्रेटेड फ्रॉम योर एंटीरियर पिट्यूटरी. ओके, सो वी विल जस्ट सी इन जस्ट बेसिक्स ऑफ वॉट इज द हार्मोन एंड वॉट इज द मेन फंक्शन. थायरॉयड स्टिमुलेटिंग हार्मोन. ओके, TSH. It is necessary for growth and secretory activity of the thyroid gland. Again, in details about this TSH, you will study in your next chapter, that is your thyroid gland. The next type of hormone is your adrenocorticotropic hormone or ACTH. It is necessary for the structural integrity of or the and secretory activity of your adrenal cortex. Adrenocorticotropic hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone. Next, follicle stimulating hormone. From the name itself, in males it acts on your testosterone, which will accelerate the process of spermatogenesis. In females, again, it has many effects. First one is in the development of the Graafian follicle. Again, we will see this later on. Again, it stimulates the theca cells of Graafian follicle, which will release estrogen. Again, it has a promoting activity on the granulosa cells, which results in conversion of your androgen into your estrogen in females. So follicle stimulating hormone in males accelerates process of spermatogenesis. In females, it is helpful for the development of your Graafian follicle. Then the next hormone is your luteinizing hormone or LH. Again, in males, it is stimulates the interstitial cells of leading in testis. Okay, and again essential for secretion of testosterone from your leading cells. Females, again, it causes maturation of your vesicle follicle into Graafian follicle along with the follicle stimulating hormone. Induces synthesis of androgens from the theca cells of your graphic and follicle responsible for ovulation. The important one here is necessary for the formation of corpus luteum, and it activates the secretory functions of corpus luteum. So in females, mainly in the formation and secretory activity of corpus luteum, and in males mainly for the secretion of the testosterone from your Leydig cells. So what is left? The last one is your prolactin. It is necessary for the final preparation of your mammary glands for production and secretion of milk. So these all hormones, when we'll go to the coming classes, that is your thyroid or adrenal cortex, so we will study in details about these hormones. Here in today's chapter, growth hormone is very, very important, and you have to remember it by heart, learn regulation and functions of growth hormone. It is a long question for you. Next class, posterior pituitary, again we will see in details about two hormones. What are the two hormones in your posterior pituitary? What are the two hormones in your oxytocin and vasopressin, ADH? Okay, yes, very good. So ADH and oxytocin we will study next class in details. Those two again are very, very important hormones. Next class again we will see the applied aspects of the diseases that are concerned with your pituitary gland. Again we will that is also a very important question when coming to your pituitary hormones. So we are over with today's class. If you have any doubt in today's class, you can ask me or ask me next class. But growth hormone, I am repeatedly telling you, is very, very important